My top three passions are the music, the variety that we have in our worship services, the opportunities to be part of that by being a Eucharist or an usher or bring up the plates, certainly the outreach of taking communion to those at home, and education for ministry. That's been my favorite. I'm thinking about heretics, though. They sound pretty interesting, and I think I'd like to take a crack at that. Maggie Cullman. Maggie reached out to me very early on in my coming here. And the first year, she and I were roommates at the Episcopal Diocesan Conference. Let me get it right. It was fantastic, and she was very, very generous about helping me through some rough patches that I've had. Just recently, I was really depressed a couple months ago, and Maggie said, let's go to lunch. And we did, and it was so wonderful. So what I find in the parishioners here is that there's always a hand out, an ear open, and a heart. I find Christ in my life on the streets of Annapolis every day. You know, we have almost 4 million tourists a year, and I live right down in the heart of Annapolis. And it's a very kissing city. There are many, many couples who kiss on the streets. It's great fun. And you can tell they're visitors because they're rolling their little bags behind them. But maybe 3 or 4 years ago, I started saying good morning or hello or something like that. And to everyone I meet, and their faces are delighted, absolutely delighted. So I find Christ in that. St. Margaret's has a tremendous outreach, not just locally, but internationally. And over the last couple of years, I've been involved in a couple of projects in Tanganyika, which I can't wait to go to. I think a group of us are actually going to go there this fall to see the Dagaina girls. And I can't wait to get back to Africa. I love Africa. But Lighthouse Shelter, there are many people I see on the streets who have been to our programs for winter relief. And living right downtown, there are a lot of homeless people, or at least wanderers, and they always welcome a smile. So St. Margaret's is a joy. It's a joy to our community. It's a joy to us who go here. And it's a joy in the diocese itself.